So hey guys, and you're back with IDED of IDEDOnline for some more Tesla Effect, a Tex Murphy adventure. So in the last time, we'd just literally been in here. This is the Brew and Stew coffee shop, and we've spoken to the guy in there basically in regards to what's going on to see if we could get some information on basically ourselves as well as what's going on with the shooting. He didn't seem to have heard anything, but he has suggested that we go see a doctor, but we're not going to do that quite yet. First things first, we're going to see if we can find this other hotel where the renovations are going on, and then we're going to try and get a ladder so we can get up and into that window just up there in the electronic shop so we can see what's going on or if there's anything there that's going to help us. So we've got, this is our car, so there we go. So at the moment the only place we can go is our own office. So there's our quite funky Blade Runner-esque car. It looks very cool. Okay, so that's the abandoned newsstand.
Chelsea's newsstand is completely abandoned. I need to find out what happened to Chelsea.
So, alright, so what have we got here? So, Free Cards to Midnight.
Free Cards to Midnight isn't open right now. I'll have to try back later.
Ooh, but there is.
Archie helped me out on my Pandora Directive case where we met a charming fellow named Jackson Cross.
I'm going to do you the favor of a lifetime. I'm going to let you walk. But if I catch you meddling in NSA affairs one more time, I'm going to put a bullet right in your eyeball. Is that clear?
Nice guy.
Get this puke head out of my office. I'll be watching you, Murphy.
Very friendly. Very cheery.
Man, I thought this would have ended up in the Andes Mountains. Looks like Rusty's fun mass building has been converted into a Knights of the Templar clubhouse. It's closed. Most businesses on Chandler Avenue won't open until later.
Okay.
Closed. Yeah, this building's been a lemon for anyone who's tried to open a business.
Of course. So, we're looking for a hotel. Alright, so here's the Golden Gate Hotel, so...
Wow. This place really has been renovated. I guess that dumbbell Ardo must have come into some money. But as I walk to the counter, I suspect this place is under new management.
Holograms of people too.
Welcome in. Welcome to the Golden Gate Hotel. How can I help you? Mr. Murphy?
Wow. Patron comment.
Service around here has gotten a lot better and a lot smarter. Call me Tex.
No, thank you. The last time I tried that, you were all...
I'm a professional and should be treated as such.
For some self-righteous baloney like that. Management heard about it and I didn't get any time off for a month.
Well, I don't need many button-activated women, although it'd be a great optional feature.
Hush.
What's your name?
You know very well who I am. Holly Graham. Cute, right? You tangibles just can't resist a pun.
Dairy me.
Oh, yeah. We humans love the lowest form of humor. Speaking of which, holograms are people, too. I mean, what kind of a joke is that?
So you can read. It's for the hologram rights movement.
I hate to tell you this, but holograms aren't people. And I ought to know, because I've dated a few.
That's exactly what they used to say about minorities, women, and mutants. It's our turn now. I'm officially on strike.
Ooh. Yeah, I think I love the naming of these options. They're really cool. I don't know why it really appeals to me.
Well, more battery power to you.
Really? Oh, dear.
The last person I thought I'd hear that from. Everyone in this neighborhood's afraid of you, you know.
Go on then, crust wires.
I think you may have the wrong Mr. Murphy. A little Q&A might clear that up.
Sure. Though I should warn you, I don't get out much. Now that I know you support the hologram rights movement, I may have to reevaluate my opinion of you.
Cool.
I heard gunshots, and then the speeder came flying out and took off.
Okay, so she did hear something.
Well, it's no Golden Gate Hotel, is it? We keep
ladder?
Everything like that over at the Snow White Warehouse.
Snow White Warehouse, okay, Snow White Warehouse. Need to remember that.
I think he came in one time with Mojo, the kid from the barbecue place. It was awkward.
Fair enough.
Taylor's my bestie, my real friend. I don't know what she's doing with you.
Oh, wow. Harsh.
The nicest tangible I've ever met. Oh, you know me. Just a hologram. Here to serve my tangible oppressors. I've heard they keep a key or something to get inside the warehouse by the door.
Okay. So, I'm assuming she means by the door of the warehouse. So, basically, you know, the classic hidden under the door list
ideal.
Hotel
lobby and see if there's anything here that could help me out.
Right, well, newspaper? No, apparently not.
Forget it, Jake. It's a Chinatown sale. Could use a throw pillow.
Oh, don't say that. Nobody likes throw pillows.
Well, hopefully ballroom renovations include installing an actual ball pit.
we can only hope, Tex. We can only hope.
I'm surprised people still read newspapers, but admittedly, they bring a nice nostalgia.
Okay, so that's where the clerk was. Is there anything around there? No. Okay. What's this around
here? When visiting Salt Lake, be sure to visit...
Oh, key.
It's a key to a lockbox.
Well, that'll most probably come in useful later.
Only guests of this hotel are allowed entrance through here.
Okay. And I'm assuming we can't go through there either. Okay, so we've looked around, so we've at least got a lockbox key from here. Let's get back out. So is that most probably is the warehouse? Yes, it is. Okay, so let's head over and see if we can find the key.
I'm pretty sure every one of your cases involves the Snow White Warehouse somehow.
Oh, look at that.
What do we got here? Looks like instructions to get into the Snow White Warehouse.
Awesome.
That's the Snow White Warehouse. Yeah, needs a key.
Okay, so let's have a look at our instructions we've just found.
What do we got here? Looks like instructions to get into the Snow White Warehouse.
New code is 4268.
Yeah, needs a key.
Okay, so let's see if the key we've got. Ah, nice. Okay, so it's 4268. Nice.
Some familiar names on the Chandler Avenue sex offender list.
Okay, so let's check this place from top to bottom.
That's the Snow White Warehouse.
Okay.
Well, the owners must have really raised the rent on this place. There's hardly anything
left
on these
shelves. So dark. So dark in here that I cannot see anything whatsoever other than the creepy, creepy clown.
Is this still here? I used this to deal with a cunning criminal on my Under a Killing Moon case who had a bad case of bozophobia.
Are we gonna get, yeah, we're gonna get a cut sequence for that, of course. Why not? That has to be the stereotypical scream I've ever heard, and real comedy there.
He wants to show me firsthand when he gets out of prison. I'm not really looking forward to that.
All right, I'm going to have a quick look in the options. Are there any options that adjust the brightness? Yeah, screen brightness. Let's take that up a bit, shall we? Because I'm sorry to say that this is way too dark in here. If I can't see it, I'm pretty damn sure you guys on your end won't be able to see it. So, there's no point in playing a game where neither of us get to see anything that's going on. So, alright, so there's no ladder down here. Typewriter?
Looks like an interesting read. Looks like an interesting read.
So the whiskey? No? No. Okay, so chair. Switch. Oh, something moved. Ah, so there's the ladder that I need.
Now that I have a ladder, I can get into the second floor of the electronics shop.
Excellent. So let's get out there and let's get over to the electronics shop. So far, so good. So we're progressing down the storyline quite nicely. Okay, so if we look at it, maybe go into here, get our ladder, click that. Yep, there we go.
Nice ladder.
And so we can just climb up. Ooh, that was a little bit glitchy there. Okay, so there's the bullet hole. So let's have a look.
Oh, I was anti-habition myself.
Down there. Looks like there's blood on the floor. Nothing too interesting on the shelves. Very interesting. We'll have a look at that in a second.
Someone needs to update their poster collection. And that's a damn shame. This guy was working diligently to get a free sub at Inspector Burns' barbecue.
Can we not take that so we can get a free sub?
This guy was working diligently to
Apparently get not.
Someone needs to update their poster collection. Prohibition ended 100 years ago.
So what's this?
Spying on the citizens of Chandler Avenue.
Looks like it's pointed over at the pawn shop. Interesting. Okay, so let's have a look at this then. Okay, I'm not 100% sure there. So it's blue, pink, yellow. Oh my goodness, I'm not going to remember that. Is it that one or that one? Ah. So there, 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 there. Those two, that one, that one. Oh, and that one. Deary me. There, 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 and there. It's gonna get more and more complex. That one, that one. Oh my goodness, I'm never gonna remember this. That one, that one, that one, that one. Oh my goodness. My memory's not that good. I'm missing the first one. It's flashing up really quickly, but I'm not seeing it. Oh, it's there, then there. Ah, there's no way I'm gonna remember this routine. I'm gonna have to write this down. So we had to get this. So it's there. Oh no, oh my goodness. Alright, I need a pen. I need a pen and paper. I have a phone. I have a phone. Alright, let's get this. Let's get this right. Because there's no way I am not going to succeed on doing this because I need to do this. So let's go in and get a memo app up. Now, merely, I suppose, with these sort of games, one should always have a pen and paper at hand anyway, because you're going to need it. It's just a reality. So let's go into docs. Let's skip all that, and then let's just add a new doc. So, new document. And we're just going to put in... I suppose we could do it on colour. Then the colours are too familiar. I'm not 100% sure how I'm going to do this. This first one is orange. So let's put OR for orange. The next one was this one down here. It was green, wasn't it? So that's GR for that green at the bottom. Then I think it was this one. And what is that? That's what they say, light orange. So let's put LOR. Then the next one, that. No. It's yellow, green, that one. It's that one down there, which is just... So let's put that as B-O-R for the bottom orange. So, right, so we've got orange. Oh, no. I'm going to have to segment this, aren't I? So it's that one. Then it's that one. Then it's that one. Then it's that one. And then it's one of these. That one, that one, that one, that one. So we'll use that next one as T-O-R. Okay, so we're gonna try this again. So orange, green, the lower orange, the bottom orange, and then a top orange. And then was it red? That one, that one, that one, then very top green, top green. So let's put that one in. So we're gonna put TGR, top green, and then it was, yep, okay, so we're gonna have to put RGR for bright green, and I don't remember what the last one is. So let's try this again then, shall we? So orange, green, low orange, bottom orange, top orange, top green, bright green. And it was one over here, wasn't it? So let's try that one. No. Okay, so that one, that one, that one, that one, that one. Ah, so it's the bottom left pink. Okay, so I think we've got the full routine here. So we've got orange. We've got green. We've got low orange. We've got bottom orange, we've got top orange, we've got top green, we've got the right green, and the bottom left pink. Okay, so what did that actually do for us beyond wasting my time? I have no idea. Ah! Awesome. Ah. Oh. It's not even a real person, it's a dummy.
No. Don't shoot.
Or he's dead already, by the looks of it. He looks like he's already been shot. Watch out for tripwires or something, just in case. Maybe? No? Apparently not. Just gonna go for it. See, most people would have taken the gun out of his hand first, just in case. So what's in the secret hidden room? Oh. A force field. Because why wouldn't that be there? Poor old Tex. Gets his mojo on, or dial M for more on. Obviously, taking the mick out of the dial M for murder.
Following our first lead, and we get ourselves caught in a laser net. All in a day's work, right?
Smart Alex had a point, but I wasn't going to let him have the satisfaction of knowing so. There was one good thing about spending hours stuck in a laser net. You've got time to think. Who is this guy? Who killed him? What kind of surveillance was he doing right across from my apartment? And what's in the metal canister? Have 7 years really passed without me remembering it? Is it related to my head injury or the injection mark on my arm?
Well, it looks like we're about to find out. I assume he's just coming for the canister.
Is he dead?
Well, I think you missed a hell of a party.
party?
Yeah, you're here in time for the laser show.
I wouldn't do that. I was here to meet Carlos Maldonado. Is that you? Or him?
Look, I just stumbled onto this little nightmare, and I need to find out who this guy was and what he was doing. I'm a PI, and I assume this guy is Maldonado. My name's Murphy. Who are you?
Mason said Maldonado was a PI. Were you working with Mason too?
I'll be honest. I don't know if I was working for Mason or not. Actually, I'm having severe memory problems here, so anything you can tell me about Maldonado or Mason or what's in the cryo chamber here would be greatly appreciated.
I think I set off an alarm when I came in here. I don't usually do this kind of thing. I was just trying to help Mason. He said, come in here, find the PI, get the cryo chamber, and keep it safe.
Hey, I found that first.
Slow learner. You have to find Mason. I think he's in trouble with bad people. I don't know why. He's a neurologist, for God's sake. But you have to promise me that if I let you go, you won't come after me. You'll find Mason.
Oh, I promise. My fingers are so frozen, I can't cross them.
If your memory problems are part of all this, Mason is the only one who can help you. So you need to find him and bring him back safe just as much as I do. I'll be in contact soon.
Good stuff. Yes, I'd be dubious as well.
Man, those cops are getting close, but I don't want to leave this place without a... Not even one crate of mixers. This guy...
Right.
Tough break, hombre.
Alright, let's take whatever we can get our hands on.
In handy.
Alright, so that's what the second
is. Strictly speaking, I would never encourage anyone to break the law, but those sirens are getting awfully close, and a life sentence for a machine can last a very long time, so move!
Okay, alright, let's get out of here.
As I try to make my great escape down the ladder, I find two officials waiting to greet me.
Ah, well, could have predicted that, eh?
Hello, boys.
Well, if it isn't Tex Murphy, what were you doing in there?
Well, it's a little hard to
Oh, you know the drill.
Really trying to get my hands on that surveillance equipment. Maybe I could see exactly what happened to me. Now the only way I'll find it is if New San Francisco's finest decides to play ball with me. I don't know why they'd start now, but I'd better polish up on the old Murphy charm.
Whether you're a mutant or a normal, San Francisco is our home. Be a part of the solution to crime. If you see something suspicious, please report it to the SFPD immediately.
I got about a million things to do, and wasting time on you ain't one of them.
Didn't take you long to get in trouble, did it? You here to turn yourself in?
Danwich? I hardly recognized you. What, been 10 years? You were still a patrolman back then.
I'm surprised you remember me.
I may not have told anyone this before, but you're actually my favorite patrolman.
In case you didn't get the memo, I head up the department now. And things aren't as loosey-goosey as they were under Malden.
Okay, so... Well, this... I would like more information on Chelsea, but...
Yeah, I gotta admit, Malden did like his gooseys a little loosey. So why is it you think I came down here to turn myself in?
Well, we just found you at a crime scene with a dead body. That dead body happens to be Carlos Maldonado, a PI working in the same neighborhood as you. Is that your way of intimidating the competition?
Let's say direct marketing.
Seems a little extreme to me. Flyers and discount coupons have always worked much better for me.
I was just reviewing your file when you came in.
Is that a lot? Because it looks like a lot.
August, 2047. Peak Nariz. NSFPD informant. Beaten and hospitalized after providing information about Tex Murphy. Nariz refused to identify his assailant. No charges ever filed. November, 2048. Surveillance video shows suspected extortionist Jen Lee leaving the Golden Pagoda with Tex Murphy, never to be seen again. The case remains unsolved. Shall I go on? In the past few years, you've gained quite a reputation for yourself. You've got New San Francisco's criminal underbelly running scared.
Sounds good.
You're a cop. Isn't that the way you like your criminal underbellies?
We arrest criminals so they can be tried in a court of law. We don't just kill them, and I won't tolerate vigilantism.
Yes, of course.
What were you doing there?
I suppose we're gonna have to go for victim blaming.
I just found out he was spying on me. I followed the trail and saw that Maldonado had surveillance equipment aimed at my office. I want to find out what he recorded.
Who cares what he recorded? If you're such an upstanding citizen, you've got nothing to hide, right?
What way of putting it? Come on.
You're not gonna check inside my toilet tank, are you?
I don't even think you're joking about that. You're free to go, Murphy. For now. Any questions?
Well, if we can ask anything, then let's ask some.
I'm not sure what to think of you, Murphy.
Helpful.
I have no evidence of an abduction. Just a dead body and only one person of interest. It might be in your best interest if you could find out what happened.
Well, yes, that's what I'm trying to do.
That whole neighborhood seems to attract more than its fair share of trouble.
Of course, let's ask about, obviously,
as
Chelsea.
As far as the coroner and the commissioner were concerned, finding Chelsea's remains in your speeder were enough to pronounce her legally dead.
Oh, well. Fair enough then, so we know.
She's an investigative reporter at the Bay City Mirror. One of the less obnoxious ones.
Okay.
I know Maldonado was a dirtbag, but unless it's in self-defense, killing somebody, even a dirtbag, is a crime and will be prosecuted.
Well, as far as we're aware, we didn't do it. It was whoever was obviously breaking in and getting us.
Probably has some useful information on it.
Oh, great advice. If you could help me break it, then I'd be impressed. Guess I'll have to see if anyone else on the street can break it for me.
All right, so we're not going to have to do it ourselves from our computer then. Okay. Well, so... anywhere else open? How about this place?
It's closed. Most businesses on Ricard's at midnight isn't open right now. I'll have to try back later.
The pawn shop, maybe?
Looks the little gremlin who runs the pawn shop.
Looks like that's the one.
I've heard that his hard shell is hiding a heart of gold. But if it was, he'd cut it out himself with a rusty soup can lid.
Classy.
Murphy! Here, let me look at you. Louis told me something terrible has happened. I've been worried sick.
Well, I appreciate the concern, but other than a weird case of amnesia, I'm fine.
But Louis says you're behaving like a totally different person.
It's not me, it's you. The way we were.
When do you care about what happens to me? Don't tell me your little Grinch heart has grown 3 sizes in the last 7 years.
Oh, Lord. Please don't tell me that lump on your head has turned you back into the pathetic, pestering PI I used to know. This is a nightmare.
Hold on. Are you telling me the text I turned into was not pathetic and pestering? Those are my secret weapons.
Look, Murphy, I'll grant you have some detective skills, but it was all relentless, annoying banter and endless questions to me. I imagine my surprise when, over the past few years, you turned into someone I could actually tolerate.
Oh, wow, thanks. Yeah, 10 okay. things you love about me.
So what was it you loved most about the new me?
You cut out all the chit-chat and became a no-nonsense customer who pays in cash. You always seem to have plenty of cash.
Okay, I'll cut the chit-chat. Just tell me where I come up with all this cash.
All my transactions are done in strictest confidence. That hasn't changed.
Yeah, but they're transactions with me. Come on.
I'm having a few rough days here, Rook, and all I'm trying to do is get my memory back. I could use a little help.
Fine.
Yeah, if you like me so
much. Though I don't know anything that could possibly explain what's happened to you. Believe me, I'd tell you if I did. Now I suppose this is where you ask if I mind answering a few questions, but this is not for old time's sake.
Okay.
You became a sullen, short-tempered bully. And I miss that desperately.
Oh, great.
I heard a commotion and saw a crazed man running willy-nilly down the street and two other men in pursuit.
Okay.
I was hoping they would tear that flophouse down. And they would have, too, if it weren't for that meddling Clint.
Hmm. Interesting.
Such an upbeat, chipper little man. Utterly obnoxious. I went there once, never again. What with that herbal tea and incense, it's a veritable gas chamber. Oof. I knew she'd get nothing but trouble being with you.
Oh, thanks for that.
Louis's niece is an absolute delight. What she sees in you is an absolute mystery.
Cody's a real charming guy, isn't he?
A prince among men makes me wish I could still eat solid food. Years ago, after Chelsea disappeared, you came to me looking for leads to some valuable items, among them a lost Fabergé egg. You left the street for a long time. When you returned to Chandler Avenue, you seemed like a different person, darker, more dangerous.
Hmm.
I understand you have a thing for holograms. Maybe she's just your type.
Charming.
I'm sure you know much more about that than I. Some say you know exactly what happened.
Well, we saw the bit of video clip earlier, so yeah, we do know exactly what happened.
That's the man you think was abducted? The one I saw being chased down the street? I never heard his name before you told me.
Seems suspicious.
What is that?
Of course. Oh, so he's not going to help with that, then.
He puts the PI in pig. I heard you two had something of a rivalry going on.
Oh, so maybe we were something to do with it.
Next question.
I have no more.
Now that Rooks is open, I'll bet his back gate's open, too.
So can we go through here?
Behind Rooks' pawn shop is a dirty, ugly alcove that reminds me a lot of Rook.
Basketball?
Yeah, I used to come back here and shoot hoops until I threw my back out.
Of course you did, Tex. Oh,
ten
maybe
seconds
yes, you did.
Down by one. Murphy has the ball. He fakes. He drives. It's a 360. He's fouled.
What the hell is that?
It's Rook's hydropod garden. Whenever I see this, I think of Gordon Fitzpatrick from my Pandora case.
I assume we're getting another clip
I've
now.
I've got anti-hydrogen pods on board, and I've got to get this as far away from Earth as possible.
Pods?
Pods. Anti-hydrogen pods.
He wasn't from around here, or even from this solar system.
Looks very painted on the back of the house. So can we sneak in? No, Okay. Tennis racket. There's a ladder.
This door's just painted on.
Is it? It doesn't look
this
like
door's
it's painted,
just painted on.
Painted on. Like that isn't creepy.
I knew there was something creepy in there.
Yeah, it looks like something out of a horror game.
Ah, yes. Llama Claus would bring packs of cigarettes to all the good children around the world.
Okay, so there doesn't seem to be much point for why I got up here. So what have we got on us? We've got a few things. Ah, it's a broken zipline trolley.
Too bad this zipline trolley is broken. It's missing a wheel.
Okay, so we need a wheel. And then, where would we put it up? I'm not 100% sure.
I get the funniest feeling that some creep is staring at me. This became a highly sought-after neighborhood post-World War III when it was found that the radiation couldn't penetrate through all the lead paint.
Okay, alright then, let's go back down then. There's obviously nothing I can achieve up here. But I suppose with that in mind, we are at the point where I suppose I'm going to have to wrap up this episode. So we've got a little bit further, we found out a bit more information.
I remember
and
the day I came back to my office.
I assume maybe we'll make some more progress in the next episode as we try to figure out what's going on. I'm not really too sure. I wonder if you know anything more than I do. Of course, feel free to give me some information,
but
don't post spoilers. That's all I ask. I don't want anyone ruining it for me.
Until they realized Pug was a mutant, and it was like they couldn't care less. I guess people are a little apprehensive about taking that bottle back for deposit.
So yeah, so then just don't post any spoilers, but obviously if anybody wants to offer any help or guidance, then feel free to give me tidbits, because of course, I'm always interested in any help I can get. It's always good to get a little bit more advancement and a little bit more direction, maybe. But still, till next time, this is IDED, signing off. And remember, hit that little thumbs up in the bottom corner if you enjoyed this video, and subscribe if you want to stay up to date with this series as it progresses. So, hopefully, I'll catch you all very soon.